Now are its night. Now, what is the theme for tonight? Does anybody know?
UFO!
Sassy!
Sassy UFO. Oh, yes. Now, it's my theory that all UFOs are sassy. It's my theory. Can you hear me now, darling?
Yes,
alright. It is my theory that strangers pick you up in the middle of nowhere and give you an anal probe, and that doesn't make you feel sassy that you're doing it wrong. But actually, I'm very glad they picked this particular theme tonight, because finally, I can tell a story I have been waiting 20 years to tell. See, I once, too, was abducted by aliens. It's true, no. It's kind of a self-fulfilling prophecy, because I've been obsessed with aliens for almost 3,000 years. I was in India in 2000 BC, and one of my ex-boyfriends was writing the Vedas, and I became obsessed with their sky chariots. I just thought it was the most amazing thing ever. But, you know, I could never really find one. I mean, there were monkey kings and this and that, but the sky chariots never showed up. And I became disillusioned. So I said, okay, if you're really looking for aliens and UFOs, you've got to go to the pyramids, right?
Right.
Yes. So I went to Giza. It was wonderful, but I did discover that, Anakin and Skywalker and I do have something in common. We both hate sand. So I kept traveling west, and, you know, headed to Central America, to the dread pyramid of And it was wonderful, you know, there's no sand, it was all jungle, it was great. And I hung out for about 2 or 3 years, but, you know, how seriously can you take a serpent with feathers that never shows up? It just doesn't work, darlings. So I decided I'd have to do something about it myself. So I called all my friends, well, you know, with, like, you know, the coconuts and kind of clap them together there, and told them to meet me down in the Atacama Desert down in Peru, and I made my way south through the jungle. Now, do you know how many psychoactive compounds are in the jungles of Central and South America? Lots, yes, lots, but even modern Western science can't name them all, but I can. Yes, I can. So I foraged way before it was hip, and made my way down to Atacama Desert, and we took all the drugs and started drawing lines in the sand. Runways coming down. Hear me, O gods of the sky, bring your chariots of fire down to us. Now, I can hear you silently judging me. Drugs in the desert with all of your friends. That sounds really Burning Man, Empress. But you know what? It was 500 AD. Burning Man sounds like me. I mean, we did it. We did it right, you know. We drew our lines. We sewed together llama skins and into bags, and I talked into the bags and filled them with hot air and hung baskets and flew over and looked at all of our beautiful designs. The really important ones are the lines and the runways. That spider, I don't know what the deal was. It took those dark red berries that day, and oh my god. So don't say Burning Man to me, because, you know, go-karts that glow in the dark and have fully articulated balsa wood ladybug bodies, that's just amateur hour. So, well, you know, eventually we ran out of drugs and we all came down and still knew aliens. So, flash forward to 1997. And I'm in Phoenix. Phoenix, Arizona, hanging with my bestie, Stevie, and we're all out on her back patio. And, you know, we've got one of those little, Waiting to Exhale, one of those little terracotta fireplaces that looks like a little pear and a chimney up top. They're called chimneas. Isn't that That's a fun word to say. Chimenea. Come on. Chimenea. Yeah, they're totally useless, but they're fun to say. So anyway, so there Stevie and I are, and we see, coming over the Valley of the Sun, five lights in the sky. Now, have you heard about this? The 1997 UFO sighting all across Phoenix. Yes, YouTube is filled with conspiracy theories about that event. Well, they're all bullshit because they were there to pick me up. They had seen my drawings in the desert, but you know, it takes light years for that image to get to their home planet. And so they finally shown up. About 2,500 years later. It's wonderful. So there I was, and they you know, shot their little beam down at me, and of course I did a little coquettish when I was floating up. Bye, Stevie. Oh, Stevie, fire Lindsey Buckingham again, please. Do it. So, anyway, they took me up there, and it was me and the aliens, and they're so cute. They were just but with really big eyes. It was like living in a world of Keen paintings. And so they were there, it was me and the aliens, and then they had all these cows. You know, apparently they're very obsessed with milk. They don't have it on their planet. That's a thing. I don't know. So anyway, they started to explain to me how space travel is actually very difficult. It's actually, if you have a fast and light drive, it's actual time travel because you're beating the light from one place to the other. I could give you an hour's lecture on light cones and relativity, but let's just say they reverse the polarity on the tachyon beam and put it through the main deflector dish and just leave it right. So they were actually coming from a planet that had already seen 20 years into the Earth's future, and they wanted to know if I wanted to know what was going on. I'm like, yes, of course I do. It's the late 90s. Everything's awesome. So they downloaded the next 20 years of Earth history into my head. Needless to say, I lost it. So, you know, when you hear about alien cattle mutilation, yeah, that's not the aliens, honey. You know, when I lose it, empires fall, volcanoes, oh, what I did to those cows. Let's just say I emptied their guts onto the floor and played in it like a rain puddle as if I was a toddler. But I eventually got over it. And the aliens did have to explain to me that it was a very dangerous thing they'd done because I can't share my foreknowledge of the future because, you know, the universe will collapse and we'll all die and, you know, existence itself will end. And I said, why? Why did you tell me then? And they said, well, we've been watching this shit show for 20 years and we thought one of you should fucking know what's going on. So they put me back down on Earth and there I was in a field surrounded by cow corpses. And I made my way back to Stevie's and we drank some Catalina margaritas and it was wonderful. You know, no one calms you down like Stevie Nicks. Anyway. So, I have been living in hell for the past 20 years, and today is very special, because the last thing I had foreknowledge of was Sean Hannity. I can actually say it out loud, and look, the universe didn't end. And yeah, I just want you to remember that I could have killed the universe, but I didn't. Because of you lovely, lovely lemon drops. Yes. So, I just want to leave you tonight with the thing I've been wanting to say for 20 years. Elizabeth Warren for president.